everybody. It's good to see you all here. You know, wondering whether we're going to be inside or outside has just been, you know, a moment by moment thing. Annie said to me this morning, all through COVID we were able to worship outside and now we can't get a Sunday. Well, we just can't. And so I might as well address the next two Sundays we'll be worshiping inside. If you look at your bulletin, there's an insert, and it tells you about the people that are going to be filling the pulpit. Next Sunday, while we are on vacation, Elder Ted Predko is going to share his faith journey and his path of faith in his life. And I think a lot of us know some of it. I don't know that anybody knows all of it, because like Rick said, it's like the tip of the iceberg every time you talk to Ted. But he has a plan for that, and I'm really excited that he's willing to share with you. Kenny will be our liturgist that day. Donna Schroth will lead the children's moment, and there will be a congregational singing for the hymns. So y'all come prepared and ready to sing. On the 14th, my friend, Steve Rigotti from Worthington Church, will be coming to share the word with you. Steve is a young pastor, just recently ordained. He's a really super nice guy. He lives in Natrona Heights and has an engineering degree from the University of Pittsburgh at Drexel and lots of other things going on for him. He's bivocational. So in the daytime, he works with an agency, and I'm not sure the name of it, that works with nuclear power plants all over the world. So in the morning, he can be talking to somebody from the Ukraine, and in the afternoon, he can be speaking with somebody in a totally different country. I said to Steve, how do you know what they're saying? He goes, my translator on my phone tells me everything. So I'm excited that Steve will be here to share with you. I tell you these things so that you make an effort to be here to support the people that are taking my place. And I think you'll have a great time in worship. The flowers this morning, I didn't get that in the bulletin because I was trying to prepare a bulletin that was going indoors or outdoors. The flowers this morning are given to the glory of God and for the promise of new beginnings by Chris and Jody Mary. And so we thank you for those flowers today. Your announcements are looking ahead announcements. They look ahead to the month of July since it's tomorrow. And so you'll see our elder is Debbie Reisinger, the deacon is Jimmy, and our property manager is Dave Schroth. The offering counters are Nancy, Debbie, and Donna. So thank you all for sharing your time and your talents in the month of July. You'll see the birthdays listed there, the anniversaries, and then the church calendar for the next few Sundays and days of July. The Bethel men are out of rotation, but they will be meeting today at 6 p.m. And this is an important meeting because it's important for them to be together, but it's also an important night to discuss the upcoming community arts day. So, are there other announcements that need to be made at this time? Yes, David.
If we need the congregation to have anything worthy to advertise, please get that to me.
This morning, as I looked at the worship schedule, I thought, so do we acknowledge and celebrate the 4th of July today, before it happens, or next week after it happens, because it's right in the middle. So we're going to celebrate it today. And having said that, I would like you to give your attention to the screen. There's a video, God Bless America, and it'll set the tone for the beginning of worship.
Thank you.
Matt lifts the lights. Would you please stand and join me in the first hymn of this morning, My Country Tis of Thee, number 561 in the hymnal or on the screen. Of our heart, our prayers, all be glorified to you this day. And would you please send your Holy Spirit to this gathering and to our nation as we look ahead to days that are uncertain, that cast a dim picture, remind us that it is you and you alone who have the final say. Help us to trust in you. We ask these things in Jesus' name, and all the people of God would say,
Amen.
Okay, you may be seated, but the kids need to stand up. So we started out a little slow and thoughtful, and not that we're not thoughtful here. Oh, but we're going to do the call to worship, right? Did I forget? Amazing. Join me in the call to worship as you find it in your bulletin or on the screen. Happy are those who walk in God's ways.
Blessed are those who observe God's commandments.
Faithful are those whose eyes are fixed on righteousness.
Joyful are those whose hearts are filled with praise.
Come, let us love the Lord our God.
We come to worship the one who leads us in the ways of life.
Okay, kids. Now it's time for I Am a Seed, and I need you to help the parents because they don't sing that fast. And it's hard for them to read those letters all jammed up together. So you need to be the leaders of the band, okay? Okay, Mr. Rick, we're ready. Remember the words of Paul, and let the peace that comes from Christ rule in our hearts, and then may we live in peace. May the peace of Christ be with you all. Take this moment to greet each other with a sign of peace, a handshake, a hug, a wave, and let the children come forward.